The moment David started looking into the candle, I knew he was in danger. I was frightened because I didn't know what he could see or why he was acting so strangely. And when the standing stones vanished, he started seeing visions. Then came that terrible moment at the top of the hill.
Keith,
don't be afraid of me. I know it's real.
Hello, Keith. You're all right. Just a little concussed. You're a swang. Let's stay here tonight. Get some sleep. Mum and Dad will come to take you home tomorrow.
Where's David?
Okay. I'm so sorry. It seems he was struck by lightning. David's dead. Are you all right?
Not so bad.
We thought we'd let you have a lie in. Want any breakfast?
Just some tea. I've still got an awful headache.
Eileen's, she's gone down to church. She wanted to...
It's all right. I know about David. Dr. Wicks told me. It's David's. Is David here? Take David home.
Oh, lad. It's worse than you know. We weren't supposed to tell you, but while you're asking. When I saw that lightning, I came straight over. But David, he wasn't there. There were only you. David, he disappeared.
Ben, I can't even see him.
No, lad. Not you, or us. Or Dr. Wicks. Oh dear, that poor man. He's all on his own now.
First his wife, and now his son.
Why did David get taken away like that? Why him?
Never question ways of God, lad. It's more than we know.
Well, perhaps it wasn't God that took him. Did it look like God?
He looked like lightning to me. There's a car coming. That'll be your dad.
This is it. This is all I've ever wanted.
David was gone. I'll never be with him again. Never talk to him again. He'd gone. Like the drummer boy had gone. And unless some future time brought him out again, he was gone forever.
Keith? Oh, Keith. You don't have to go to school, love. Dr. Wicks thinks you should take things very easy.
I just want to think about something else.